The name of the album is called 10 Toes Down. And the first single off the album is called DJ Bring It Back. It's a song where we kind of like pay homage back to the DJ for like inventing hip hop and stuff like that, you know, for being one of the pioneers of hip hop. It's a nitty beat track. It was like originally made for us, you know, something that all us cooked up, you know, in the lab together. And Nitty got a real good nick, you know, for working with us. Cause we helped break Nitty back in the day when he did the song for 8-Ball, Stop Playing Games. Back in the day, you know, like a lot of DJs were really, you know, like hands on, all, you know, like all in hip hop. And like today, you know, it's a lot of DJs get on just to get right on the mixtape circuit and make that money, you know. But overall though, I think the DJ has been hands on, you know, with hip hop, you know, the whole way. I think that the DJ got a real passion for it, you know, really all kinds of music. But, you know, that's who gets you interested in hearing it, you know.
Back when, you know, we first started really like getting into hip hop and rap, like the late 80s, like 88, 89, that's when we was taking it serious. And you got to think, like, then DJs were more serious about their equipment and their records and, you know what I mean, stuff like that. Like the real, you know, we still got those DJs, but most of the DJs now are more button pushers than real. Touch that record, make that record, you know, crank that crowd up. And I'm not mad at that, but you know what I mean? But it's just, you know, everything got to change. Memphis, when we was coming up, like, yeah, we was too young to like get into the clubs and stuff like that. And like DJs like DJ Spanish Fly from Memphis and DJ Sonny D, they used to DJ at all the clubs. Like Spanish Fly, we got close to him one time and he listened to our music and he used to like sneak us in the clubs. He used to DJ it, like with him, not sneak us in, but like let us in with him, you know, no ID and stuff like that. But it was like a, Memphis looked like Beach Street at that time, man. Like, you know, cats, it was a real big hip hop DJ, rap battle, beatbox type of thing going on in Memphis then, man. Yeah.
Well, let me see, the first time at the club, that one there kind of faint, cause we might have had one or two playing at the club before we had one on the radio or something. But, yeah, the first one on the radio was DJ Jackson Brown, Downtown Jackson Brown, broke our first record on the radio, was, what was that, like 90, 91? You know, it was awesome, you know. Certain feelings and moments is, you know, it's priceless. And, you know, and that was one of the moments that you can't duplicate, you know. It's just been, it's been all pretty much uphill since, you know, ever since. Yeah, man, you know, all that is still motivation. You know, what you search for is humbleness, and you know, a lot of that can either go to your head, you know, or it can humble you, you know, over time, and you know, and I believe, you know, that's what it did to us, you know. And you know, it's just humbling, you know, over time, you know, and it's just a blessing for us to still be able to be relevant right now, you know, but we still love it, you know, as if it was the first day.
You know, it's an old neighborhood phrase, man, like all over the world. I mean, well, all over the U.S. for sure. But, you know, 10 toes down, man, it just means that we are, you know, that you can use it with whatever you do. You know what I mean? Like, you 10 toes down about this Rhapsody shit, you know what I'm saying? Excuse me, but you know what I'm saying? Like, you, this is what you do, you know, whatever your passion is, man, you know what I mean? Like, it means you serious about that, you know what I'm saying? And it also means that you to us, 10 toes down, that We've been here for a while. Our feet planted on the ground, head straight forward, mind to the sky. You know what I mean? Like we gonna be here, you know, and we gonna keep our feet planted. We rooted in hip hop, Southern hip hop, and the album reflects that, you know, from the first single, Ten Toes Down, Drama Boy produced. We wanted to kind of come back on the scene with something that was real descriptive of 8-Ball and MJG, you know what I'm saying, and how we feeling now and what's going on with us now. The video is dark like the song, you know what I mean? At night, we in a scrapyard, fire and shit, you know what I'm saying? And it feels like the song, it's gritty like the song. And that's what we wanted to come across, like we kind of took from the movie Dusk Till Dawn, you know what I'm talking about? Kind of took some from that. Moby Dick, he used to be with No Limit. He produced it, it's called Right Now. And it's like a modern day blues song, rap blues song almost. You know what I mean? Like, and we just kind of, the elements of our album is classic Memphis hip hop and blues. Like, that's what you get from it, you know. We came up on all that kind of music, you know. Both of our parents brought us up on soul music and blues and R&B and stuff like that. And it's like, Memphis is a blues city, you know what I mean? So that music is like, it's in us, like, you know what I mean? So we just try to bring it across with our music in our way.
No, well, we only hoped and wished, but, you know, like the main thing that we always try to do is just keep doing what we're doing, you know, try to stay on the straight and narrow, get that tunnel sight, you know, on what we was doing. It was like it hadn't already happened overnight. They were saying, y'all boys hot and they liking y'all here and here and here. And we was just chilling. We was still just doing what we were doing. We was just in the studio, man, you know, man, just working. And this reputation of 8-Ball and MJG and stuff was out there building up. And, you know, and we didn't really know how big it was at first, you know.
We were like the original, like, rap rock stars, kind of. That's how we describe it, man. You know how, like, we wasn't really all about the business in the 90s, man. You know what I mean? Like, the people who done the business, we done the music, you know what I mean? And that's what it was about, you know? It was all about the music. It was all about living for today, you know what I'm saying? And that's how we lived then. And we didn't look at what we were crafting or what it was turning into. You know what I'm saying? And we just looked back one day and or looked up one day and people were like, you're a living legend. And yeah. You know what I mean? And that's, it just, yeah. Don't be scared to push the boundaries, man. You know, that's what's gonna make, like, that's what made music what it is now. You know, and every time something great come along, it's that artist or that band that wasn't scared to push the boundaries. You know, it doesn't work for everybody, but for those that it worked for, you know what I mean? For people that are, you know, passionate about what they do and love their music and their art form, you know what I mean? Like, that's the stuff that's gonna stand the test of time. Hip hop is forever changing. Like, all music is forever changing. But hip hop, one day it might be Kanye West, one day it might be Gucci Mane. You feel me? Like, that's, and their ranges are so far apart from each other. You feel me? But that's how hip hop is. You know what I mean? Like, so, like, you can't say who gonna be the it guy this year from what you hear. Because you, the hip hop fan, you know, you don't know what they gonna love tomorrow, man. You know what I mean? But good music is always gonna be good music, man. You know, whether it's hip hop or whatever.